One of my favorite sources for terrain is the thrift store. They're great places to find little houses and churches that are to scale with your typical 28mm Warhammer or Dungeons & Dragons figure. Usually they require a little modification, like this church, which I painted and added gargoyles to. I also expanded the roof to make it look a little less like a cookie jar. It's not a cookie jar, but it sure looked like one when I got it. Some of these churches even come with a nice enough paint job that you don't need to add anything to them, just the base. Yeah, this is a little bit Christmassy, but I can forgive it because I really like the paint that's on it right now. You can typically snatch these things up for a buck or three, which is dirt cheap, especially when compared to the equivalent Games Workshop size structures, which will run you over $100 before shipping. Sometimes I come across little pieces like these knickknacks here. I got a little gazebo and this Halloween house thing. Now on their own, they don't pass as a terrain house, but I'm gonna build a house out of foam around them. Now it's gonna take some planning and measuring so I can get the look that I want. I'm not making a swamp monster here, and I can't just sloppily slap together something. A house requires a certain amount of symmetry. So let's take a picture of the Halloween house and mock up what the house will look like behind it. So using a point of reference on the Halloween house that's an inch long, I know that I'm gonna end up needing 6 sheets to get the height I want. Looking at this Photoshop mock-up, we can see that the bottom 3 sheets can all be cut about the same. That's gonna basically be a square. The fourth one up is where we're gonna begin our roof, so that one's gonna be a little wider. And then the last two aren't even gonna be full sheets, they're just gonna be completing the roof, just tiny pieces, little slivers. Now that we've planned it all out, let's see if we can't trim some of this Halloween house down using a chisel to get a more flush fit with the foam. And no. Okay, while the glue is drying on our Halloween house, let's work on cutting the foam. I don't have a Proxon cutter, only this handheld foam cutter, so getting super straight lines is not gonna happen. I'm going to texture the side of the house using my wire cutter. Like so. Basically, I'm going to keep it even, and it's going to give the effect of wooden planks. Sorry, the shot's a little out of focus. Instead, the camera's focusing on the refrigerator, but I think you get the gist of what's happening in the foreground here. We're going to do the bottom 3 layers just like this. Now, we're going to connect those 3 layers using glue and toothpicks. This Elmer's glue is not the best for this project. In fact, what I ended up switching over to, which I didn't catch on camera, are these acid-free paste glue sticks. They're much better at working with this foam. I can't tell you why. I don't know what the difference in the makeup is. I just know that this Elmer's glue wasn't really doing much, and mostly the toothpicks here are connecting the foam. They're doing the heavy lifting. What you're looking at here, some Shiba cat food container. This is when you get the two-part. It's called the Perfect Portions container. I've got a very spoiled cat here. He lives like a French Duke. Clean those up as we would a dish. Wash them out real good because you don't want the stinky cat food smell. We're going to cut the back off with a safety knife here, and those are going to act as our windows. I also measured it out to make sure they're symmetrical and that they're placed evenly on both sides of the house. And then we're just going to sort of cut the outline of that out with our foam cutter, but ultimately we're going to have to gouge all that foam out using something. I used a screwdriver. And we're going to need to cut spaces into our little foam house for the knickknacks we're going to be using. We'll be putting our gazebo up top here, so I'm cutting that hexagon in the top there. And we're going to knock a notch out of the front of the house as well. Here we are working on the roof. This is layer 4. I just made it a 1/2 inch wider on every side. And I cut a roof pattern into the sides, and using a measuring triangle, sort of like a little plastic ruler with angles on it, I made the angles even on both sides so we get a nice symmetrical house. This is the second layer of roof, which is just angle. And here it is all put together, nothing painted, and it's just missing the very top layer of roof here, which is going to cover up that gap you're looking at. I'm going to cut that out and put that on there, and that will basically complete this project. I think I put a little bit of roof on the back as well. Here we are just attaching the mid-level portion of roof, which requires, again, glue and toothpicks. Alright, I do not care for the goofy little ghost that's on the front of this Halloween house, so we're going to cover it up with a shield, which I made from a toy in a silicone mold. This is actually made out of Durham's Rock Hard Putty. Same thing with this door. I'm just going to cut a section out of the back, glue that in, use hot glue to fill in those gaps around it. Cut the door a little hair bigger than I needed to, but once that's filled in, not too bad. Now, our windows aren't just going to be open windows. We're going to structure in there using wooden popsicle sticks. And the way we're gonna make those look right is I've got a gouging tool. I'm gonna throw those in there. I've got just one bar going across, one bar going up and down. Again, we try to measure everything out, make it nice and symmetrical. And we're gonna fill in those windows. Use a very, very dark purple I have on hand. I just have a very big jar of it. You could use black for this, obviously. I think the purple's a little more interesting, honestly. And we're gonna put the window in. I just squeeze that in. I use toothpicks to hold it in place. Also a little hot glue, which I don't get on camera. You know, I put toothpicks into holes I've made with nails. Showed myself doing that earlier. Here the house is with just one base coat of brown paint. And it already looks pretty good. Well, you're right, that is some kind of a wooden structure. After that, we're just gonna start painting up the different layers. One of the things that we have to do with this project, with the spray primer, is we can only spray prime those knickknacks, and we can't spray prime foam itself or it'll start melting. But here it is, all complete, laid out with a couple of other buildings I've gotten from the dollar store. We've got some other terrain features around and some miniatures. I think it looks pretty great, considering this cost me about $1. The foam was gifted to me, and the knickknacks cost $1 altogether. One was a quarter, one was 75 cents. As always, you can visit us on Facebook. If you'd like to support the channel, please consider making a donation to my GoFundMe campaign. The links for both are in the description below. As always, thanks for watching.